If all things, you know, don't sort of go well here today, you could certainly make a great bowl of porridge.
I suppose I could do
that's right. Well, look, congratulations and welcome to everybody. We're going to have a wonderful show today. We're going to have everybody working throughout the program. Peter Russell Clark coming in. And then we're going to find out who's going to be the chef of the year. Back in a moment with all of it.
Wonder how Merv's going. Must be in the thick of it now.
Well, Alice is on cleaning duty near the rec room this hour. I asked to sneak a look at the telly, see if she can find anything out.
What'll I do with these?
Huh? Oh, put them on the table over there. Don't you remember any of this?
Oh, yeah, sure. Bits and pieces, you know. Yeah.
What exactly happened to you prior to coming here? I mean, what sort of treatment was it?
Madam, you know we don't ask questions. If and when she wants to tell us, she can.
Oh, no, it's all right. I mean, if I could remember, I'd tell you. See, you know, I can remember some things and then not others. Well, I suppose things have changed, eh?
Yeah. Like the fact that the press isn't the exclusive property of the top dog anymore. You want to try?
Well, I don't know if I can. I might burn something.
I mean, you've never used the press before?
Should I have?
No, I guess not. Here, I'll show you. Just put the sheet here. Then you bring the handles down like this.
We better go after
her. That
yelling at the freak.
Oh, my God.
How is she? Someone bash her?
No sign of it. More like she just fainted.
Well, do we take her to sick bag?
No, I want to know why she took off in the first place. I think we should find out for ourselves first. Hey, come on. Give us a hand. We'll take her back to her dorm.
I hope Madam's covering for us.
And now it's time to go over to Los Angeles for our weekly Hollywood Roundup, and then we will be back to check out how our contestants are getting on and meet our very special guest judge, Peter Russell Clark.
OK, relax, everyone. 6 minutes on this item. Is Mr. Russell Clark out of makeup yet?
Yep, I'm here.
Hi, Peter. Great to see you.
G'day, Bob. See, we've already got him hard at it.
Yeah, we've got Francois Capri in again this year. He's doing baked trout, you know, with that beautiful brandied almond sauce that he does. I think he'd be very hard to beat. Anyway, there's the guff on the others.
Yeah, sounds as though you've already given away the prizes, Bob. Anyway, let's go and say hello to him.
Francois Capri first, I think. We might move that way.
I don't know. Little bloke over here looks as though he needs a friendly chat.
Pringle?
Keep it thin, Joycey. It mustn't be more than 1/8 inch thick at the most.
I am trying. You concentrate on the sauce. I'll look after the pastry.
I'm sorry to worry so much, but this sort of food should be prepared slowly, not pitted against the clock. Dear, dear. Well, now, where was I? Oh, yes, the sauce. Now, you did measure out the brandy, didn't you, Joyce?
Yes.
It has to be ready the moment I add the cream.
It's in that little cup to your right. Oh!
Mervyn Pringle, Peter Russell Clark.
G'day.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realise.
And his assistant, Mrs. Barry.
Joyce, actually.
G'day, Joyce.
G'day.
What are you making?
Oh, it's beef Wellington with Espanol sauce a la Pringle.
Well, let me clean your hands for
you. Oh!
My recipe. Don't worry. Look, you must have made it 1,000 times. Surely. Just quieten down.
I can't think straight. You see, I suffer from...
From stage fright. He gets very nervous under all these lights.
I suffer from stage fright too. Just quieten down. Everything will be all right.
Oh, dear, oh, dear. Look, I can't remember. And look, there's no brandy left.
Well, I'll get a bit of brandy for you. It's easy. I'll get it from the little froggy bloke up the end. Oh, you might be interested to know the little froggy bloke doesn't come from France. He comes from Ballarat.
What is it?
He said that Francois comes from Ballarat.
Hey, not so fast. That was quite a shock you had, whatever it was.
Oh, I saw something. Where are we? Thor in the laundry.
We were till he took off. I was showing the press, remember?
Oh, yeah, I remember.
Hey, what's going on? It was like you'd seen a ghost.
Maybe I did.
What?
Oh, nothing. I'm sorry I nicked off on you, Nora. I saw something.
What happened to you on the stairs?
I don't know. I'm climbing up the stairs and I don't know. I'm trying to figure out where I'm going. And the... Oh, why can't I remember anything?
Hey, come on. There's no need to panic. We'll get you there. It might take some time, but we'll get you there.
I keep getting these glimpses, see? It's like I'm looking through this old scrapbook, see? All these things I should remember, but I can't. Oh, Nora, don't let me take me back to that mental asylum. I'm not mad. Oh, no, it's just like I can't put things together.
No one's putting you back there, all right? Well, come on, we better get back to the laundry. May and Willie can't explain us away forever.
Ferguson.
The freak, what about her?
She's on the stairs. She said she was going to push me over the edge.
The freak was up there with you?
Oh, yeah. She's there with me. She's going to kill me.
They said she heard you yell at her. Look, we better get back. I'll chase her up once we get back to the laundry. Now, come on.
She's going to kill me. She's going to kill me. I'm sure.
Shall I put the beans on this?
No, they should only be boiled for a minute or two.
Mr. Pickle, you do realise we're running out of time, don't you?
Yes, but we're trying the best we can.
Not hassling, just want to make sure everything is fine.
We're nearly ready.
OK, back on air in 30 seconds.
He really is, I would say, the troll.
If you mean you've never seen anything like him before, I'd have to agree with you.
The man is... Oh, what is he worth that? Nincompoop.
I can see he's trying his best, but the poor man's simply outclassed.
If he wins the competition, I'll eat to my frying pan.
And I'll never eat anything but plain fish and chips till the day I
heard what you said. I heard what you said about my Mervyn. And I'll thank you to keep your comments to yourself. He's nervous enough as it is.
Oh, listen, lady.
No, you listen. Mervyn Pringle is one of the finest men that ever walked this earth. And even if he doesn't win the contest, he's got more talent in his little finger than you two have got in your entire bodies.
Morris, you got a minute?
Is it important? I've got a lot to do.
It's about Reb Keane.
Is she causing trouble?
She's on the end of it. Miss Ferguson's been having her.
What do you mean?
She threatened to push her off the catwalk up near the pound.
Did you actually see this happen?
No, but I believe her. And May heard Reb yelling at Miss Ferguson.
You realise, of course, this is a very big allegation.
We're not saying that she would have pushed her, but she's obviously getting some sort of fun out of scaring Reb into believing it.
Very well, I'll speak to the governor.
Thanks. She's going through enough hell at the moment without having this on top.
3 hours overtime for Mrs. Slattery, 4 for Mrs. Morris. What about Friday?
No, no, we all work normal hours except...
Why? What is it, Beth?
I didn't expect to see you.